Good morning, children. It's Mrs. Brierley here. I want to welcome you to our very first virtual celebration assembly. It's such an important part of what we do at St. Scholastica's. I'm really pleased to be able to be presenting it to you this morning, and a really warm welcome to all our grown-ups who are joining us as well. So we're going to start our assembly this morning the way we always do, by saying our school prayer together. Join your hands and we'll make the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear God, thank you for loving me. Thank you for taking care of me, listening to me at home, working with me at school, and sharing yourself with me at church. Help me to try my best in everything, especially in loving you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, let's see what we have up first this morning. We have Mathletics. And so we've been looking online to see who has made the most progress this week. And I'm delighted to say the following children have done that. And that is Noah, Millie, Kamshi, Millicent, Frederick, Rishane, Kundi, and Oliver. Well done, children. We've also been looking at children who have had the most Lexia usage this week. And so that is John, Evie, Lillian, Ruby, Dennis, and Emmanuel. Well done, everyone. So having a look online, it's really important that you keep logging on if you can. I had a look at the Lexia usage this week and it has dipped. So if you have a login, please log in. The same for Mathletics. Now, if you have trouble logging in, then call or email the school or tell a member of staff when they call you next week. So next up, I thought we'd have a quick look at attendance. I'm being quite silly here because obviously we're all at home. Well, not all of us are at home. I worked out about 97% of our children are at home, but there are a few children who are coming to school because they are key worker children. Now, if you're grown-ups, if you are if you work in health or social care, maybe education or childcare, you work for the local government, or you deal in public services, or maybe you work for our transport system, or you're a delivery driver, or you work in a supermarket, you are classed as a key worker. And so if you do need to work, there is childcare available. Please do contact the school. But for the majority of us, the 97%, we are doing what the government says and staying at home. Next up we have, we have our birthdays. So we haven't been able to celebrate birthdays since the school closure. So we've got quite a few children, some in March and some in April. So I want to say a big, big happy birthday to Eileen, Waderson, Maya, Lillian, Jaden, and in April, Marty, Amy, Okotachi, Ariam, Jacob, Samuel, Ephrata, Seteyesh, Uche, Eddie, Gloria, Ayana, Dennis, Emily, and Marguerite. And I'm sure you would agree, what could fit more perfectly than to have a world party on the day you came to be? Now, usually in this time in our assembly, we'd be thinking about things like court being good or who's going to receive our head teacher's award. And obviously we can't do that because we are not all together. So I've been thinking about ways that we can celebrate all of your wonderful achievements. And so I started thinking about, we've got some values in our school that are really important to us. They're called our super skills. I wonder, children, can you remember how many super skills there are? maybe tell a grown up or tell someone who's sitting next to you. That's right, there are six. Now, can you name all six super skills? Go on, have a go. Think of the pictures, think of the colours to help you. Can you name any more? You got them all? Well, if you got them all, well done. But I'll just remind you, our super skills are aspiration, independence, motivation, resilience, determination, and respect. And we believe that these super skills are what you need to be a good learner. They help us to show our gifts and all our values that God has given to us. And they help us with our learning. And they're not just for now, they're skills that we're going to need for the rest of our lives. So I was thinking about what super skill could we work on in the coming week? And what I've got for you is, I've got the definition. I wonder if you can guess what super skill I'm talking about. So it says being able to think or act for yourself. I wonder what super skill am I talking about? I'm sure some of you know. I'm talking about independence. And when we think about independence, I was thinking about how could we show our independence at home. So I came up with a few ideas. It might be remembering to wash your hands, because we know that that's really important now. It might be doing things like making your bed or tidying your toys away or doing the washing up and helping around the house. It might be folding your clothes. It might be doing your home learning tasks. And it also is thinking about doing what you know or is expected of you. The key thing with independence though is that you have to remember to do these things without being asked. So without your grown-up having to tell you or to remind you that you need to do these things. So I want you to really focus on independence this week. And adults, if you see your child doing these super skills consistently and really well over the course of the week, you can nominate them. So you can do that in two ways. You can email the school at support@st-scholasticas.hackney.sch.uk, or you can tell a member of staff when they call during the week. We're going to keep up with our weekly phone calls. It may not be your child's class teacher, because we are running a skeleton staff, but it will be definitely a member of staff just ringing to see how you are getting on. And so that brings us to the end of our celebration assembly this week. It's been such a delight to present this to you. Obviously, it's not the same as being all together, but it is a really wonderful way for us to have a little celebration, even though we're in our homes. So we're going to have more communications are going to be sent to you via email. So please, please do keep an eye out for them. And our next assembly will be sent out on Monday, and that will be a gospel assembly. So a chance for us to reflect on the gospel that we would have listened to in Sundays, at Sunday's Mass. So take care, stay safe, stay indoors, and I look forward to meeting again with you on Monday. Bye.